It was not long after the creation of Asgard that the Aesir came into being. The Aesir were a race of gods ruled by Odin. They included Thor, the most powerful of all the gods. A god whose strength proved larger than his mind, for it was not uncommon for him to mindlessly swing his immense hammer towards anything which bothered him. Frigg was the wife of Odin. While we know she was a high-ranking goddess, we do not know about the specifics of her powers or personality. Baldur was the son of Frigg and Odin. He was a god of purity and all things good in the world. Frigg adored him so much that she convinced every single living entity, living, dead, or inanimate, to never harm him. Except Mistletoe. But that's another story. Heimdall, the ever-vigilant guardian of the gods' soon-to-be stronghold, Asgard. Idun, a goddess who is the owner and the dispenser of a fruit which grants immortality. Bragi is a god who would soon reside in the halls of Valhalla, welcoming all the souls into the sanctum. Tyr, one of the key gods of war. Though he is also known for representing law and justice. Hymir is a strange god whose characteristics change with each telling of him. In one story, he's foolish and stupid, whereas in others, he has a distinct connection to Odin, with much of his personality and characteristics. As such, some believe him to be an extension of Odin. These new gods met upon the plains of Iðavöllr. They named the phases of time, night, morning, midday, afternoon, and evening. They built altars and temples. They utilized forges to create tools, tongs, and precious things. They had entered their first age of merriment, but all good things would come to an end. And it was marked by the coming of three female ogres. Then all power went to the thrones of the Norns, three women who control the fates of all. And the Aesir discussed who would be best to create the dwarves. From the blood of the giant Brimir, they forged the first two dwarves, Matsognir and Durin. These two made more dwarves, then came more and more until the entire race was established. Not long after, Vili, Ve, and Odin were walking along the sea and came across two trees. The brothers looked upon each other and decided to create mankind from these trees. Exactly why they chose to do this remains unknown. Perhaps they wished to populate Midgard, perhaps they desired servants to worship them, or perhaps they did it simply because they could. The sons of Bor took the two trees and shaped humans from them. One was female, the other was male. Odin gave them breath, Hænir gave them spirit, and Lodur, another obscure god, gave them blood. Once birthed, they were granted clothing by the three Aesir, and following that, names. The female was named Embla, and the male, Asker. Odin would then marry to Frigg, and from this he would create their home. Above Midgard, Odin made an immense throne for both he and Frigg, known as Hildskalf. From here, Odin looked out over the whole world and saw every man's act. And it was then that Odin became the All-Father. Because he is the father of all gods, and of humans, and all that was fulfilled of him, and of his might. Then came hundreds of halls and temples in the great rainbow bridge known as the Bifrost. This all culminated into the place we know as Asgard. And then from that came a tree which roots and branches spread, forging the remaining realms, something I will talk about in my next tale.